Oh, really? No.
Do it.
No.
Do
it.
Ridiculous.
I'm wondering where we're going with this.
How do other musicians even talk to you?
Why are we in black?
What kind of show is this?
You're totally inspiring.
I got hotel keys in every pocket.
This was a Beachcombers episode. You ripped this off.
You are watching Stripped Down.
You are watching Stripped Down, Saskatchewan's only award-winning one-hour local music showcase, the show that brings the venue to you in the comfort of your own living room. I am your host, Curtis Anderson. Really excited for tonight. All the way from Regina, Saskatchewan, ladies and gentlemen, Sinners O' Saints.
Now it's time to make a plan. It's
are watching Stripped Down. We are spending 60 minutes with Sinners, Oh Saints. Oh, we're cracking the back already. One song in. That's got to be some sort of record. Sinners, Oh apostrophe Saints.
You betcha.
Right before we started rolling, we established none of you are Irish.
No.
So I'm guessing all of you are Saints. Right?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Okay,
yeah,
why we're Sinners saints. Or Saints?
I have
why?
No idea. Honestly, we flanged up this band in a hurry.
Flanged up? Wow, that was a great
That's
verb.
Oil patch.
That
is a oil great patch verb. Terminology,
yeah.
Right?
Flanged.
Kind of. No, Wilf Dieter here, him and a girl wrote a song for
Megan?
Wayburn, yeah, Megan Leach.
Someone did his homework.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Reading up on her stuff.
Yeah. I love it when bands have really long songs first, because then I actually get to, do my job.
Yeah, right, eh? Yeah,
so,
the internet's a wonderful thing. No, it's all good.
You and
no,
Megan.
And they flanged up a song, like I was saying, for Wayburn Rider Nation, and they won it, and then he was in a hurry to get a band going. He'd already played with these guys, and then he ran into me half piled up in an open jam session one night, and we said, hey, man, let's try this out, and then one thing led to another. We hammered out about 25 songs in a week.
At Wayburn there, they had this big, huge barbecue thing for the riders and stuff, and they came out there and they wanted us to play out there, and we weren't really a band yet.
Yeah.
And they said, well, do you think you can come and at least do the one song? And I said, yeah, we could probably pull off the one song. And
you can only play one song so many times in a row, right?
Yeah, so we actually
but we've all been musicians.
Managed to pull off 20 songs, mostly covers, of course, but
it
turned out all right.
And so here we are, 8 months later, we've been in the studio, been running around doing shows, a couple different bars, different towns.
So where's Megan in all this now?
She was already living in Toronto at the time. Like, and she's an excellent singer too, eh? Mm. She actually wanted to be the singer, but she was out in Toronto. She's an actress / dancer / singer. She has like the triple threat thing going, but
there's only two bands in rock and roll where a female singer is allowed. And they're not in this province.
how would the band have been different? Because, man, I'm already digging your charisma for the front man, I gotta say.
There would be no band if it was her, not to but I'm telling you.
Wow! We're throwing
I'm
that
just
out there.
Kidding.
I feel like I need to break out the stripped down swear jar. I feel
we're
only a few minutes in. I feel like I'm going to be beeping words left and right in this episode.
That's okay, man.
Let her fly. Let her fly. It's the reason we pre-tape the show. We don't let anybody do it live.
No, she's very talented. It's actually, Megan, if you're going to end up watching this, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here right now.
Well, also,
if it wasn't for Megan, none of us would be here.
Exactly.
Right now.
No, Megan's sound, though, like her, like she's more of like kind of like a dance pop kind of funky thing.
Okay.
And Rob, like originally, like I wrote this country rock song for the thing, and I needed a country singer, so that's how Rob came to be. And so we have this country flavor to pretty much everything we play.
Yeah.
Is that where you think you'd fall in genre, country singer?
Well,
I didn't really get that.
No, I'm kind of my own, I don't know. Actually, our producer the other day when we were in the studio, he's like, you guys got like this new, he's like, yeah, man, it's like thrashabilly.
Thrashabilly?
Like, cool, man. Rockabilly, it's country
thrashabilly?
Rock.
Thrashabilly? And you're like, we're going to flange that up.
I thought he's psychobilly.
Yeah. Psychobilly. Get the pipe wrenches out and psychobilly, thrashabilly.
Yeah.
Love when bands come up from Regina. This is a show that reaches all of Saskatchewan through Shaw TV and Access Communications. We're shown in like 80 small cities and centers between the two. So love when bands come up from Regina. Thank you guys so much for making the trip.
Oh, thanks for having us, man. This is.
I'm a big fan of Regina. I know there's always that stupid rivalry going on, but like I spent so many weekends in Regina growing up. My grandma lived there, and just always liked the drive. Yeah. Always liked Regina. Was down there last weekend, actually, for the first time in about 6-7 months. There's all sorts of crazy animal warnings now. There's moose and deer and caribou warnings.
Like on the highway?
What's up with that? Where did that come in?
Probably all the moisture down there.
They're just...
Something, I don't know, everything.
Yeah, it got a little dark, the ride, because they're just kind of all over.
Yeah.
Not really grazing anymore.
No.
They're kind of seeing better days along the side
of
the road.
See a lot of land between here and Regina on the highway.
Yeah,
but the ride, the drive was okay. It was a little rainy.
Oh, yeah.
It was rainy. That was it. No animals, though. Traffic was good.
This is hardcore. We're coming down tonight. We're going to rock this thing. You guys are driving back after.
I guess
that's life of a musician.
I'm going out to an open jam tonight.
Really?
Which one?
Over at Bud's on, the Fez on Broadway.
Nice.
That one
you
I was
made
on
connections.
Last. I've been talking to a few people about getting gigs up.
Yeah, you've been here recently lining up gigs as well.
Yeah.
So primarily, though, we've been playing a lot of Regina.
Yeah, Regina, Wayburn area.
Yep.
So
yeah.
Far, so.
So taking it to the next level now, which is Saskatoon, I guess.
Well, yeah.
Saskatoon.
Of course it is.
If you're in Regina,
north,
I guess the next level is Saskatoon.
Right?
Vice versa.
Well, yeah.
We might be going more east to like Brandon and Winnipeg too, possibly.
Brandon and Winnipeg are good times. Yeah. I lived in Brandon too, but we're getting way off track.
It's all good.
What are we hearing tonight? You guys talk. You've been in the studio. Do you have an official disc yet?
We got four songs.
Okay.
We have songs that are recorded. They need to be kind of tweaked a bit before they're fully released.
Okay.
And plus, we need to put more songs on it too. We're trying to get a grant to finish the disc because it's of course costs a lot of money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they'll do that.
That's through Ralco
Radio.
Oh, and around the area.
Yep.
And
yeah.
And
I mean, all of Saskatchewan is going
really
for that.
Good.
Yeah.
And forgive me, I didn't even do introductions off the top. Introduce yourselves. And I didn't have the heart to tell you before we started rolling when you said you didn't want a microphone that the guy that turns down the microphone usually gets ragged on the entire episode by his bandmates because he can't rebuttal. So if you ever have something really witty to say, I'll just come stand.
That's right. He'll just come out back behind the woodshed and give us a few backhands later on.
All right.
He's that type of guy.
Introduce the band before we get to the end.
I'm Rob Daniel.
I'm Wolf Dieter.
Jason Spilchum.
And me. Someone introduce him. He doesn't have a mic.
Jay Bird.
Jay Bird.
The strong, silent guy.
Yeah. Jason Bird.
So we have two J's. And
J-Dog.
One's Jay Bird, and his actual nickname is Dog. So we have Jay Bird and Jay Dog.
Well, that makes more sense than RJ. His nickname's Isosolator. He's over there.
Yeah,
seriously, that's
I'll go with Dog.
I don't know if it rhymes or how that happened, but Jay became Isosolator.
Nice.
Anyway. All right. What was song one?
Man I Am.
Man I Am?
Yeah.
And what was Man I Am about?
Between Rob's my life and a lot of guys I knew and buddies over the years, I guess. Between life and running around the oil patch and just...
I was going to say, you look like the kind of guy that's got a couple stories.
Oh,
a couple
yeah.
good stories to tell.
Few. One or 7,000.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, and that will be on the upcoming disc. Is that one of the four songs you've got hammered out so far?
Yeah, that one's on there.
Okay. Where do we go from there? What was song number two?
This next one is called Ain't No Saint.
No Saint.
It's one that we all wrote back in October, November, something like that. So it's got
it was
too.
Even earlier than that. I think... October,
something.
Yeah.
It's a good little tune, just about if you listen to the words, you can kind of take it this way or that way, right? It's kind of dirty, but
I'll take it
funky.
Any way I can get it.
Yeah.
Take it away.
That's what it's about.
Ha! Always. Are you afraid? I ain't no saint. For why I've been gone, I know what I want, I know that it's wrong. But hell on wheels, most of my life, from time to time, I like to shoot out the light. And from the stage, you see what's going on, like an animal, she's coming undone. Looking at me with a hungry smile, though the screaming guitars I hear. Would you like to come inside and play? Are you afraid? I ain't no saint, yeah. You afraid? Hell yeah. Hold on. No saint. We'll be right back.
Are you afraid? Are you afraid? Are you afraid? Are you afraid? Cause there ain't no sand. Yes, I live in an opium cage. I just want to taste, but I can't escape. And would you like to come inside and play? Are you afraid? There ain't no sand. Yes, I live in an opium cage. I just want to taste, but I can't escape. Would you like to come?
Clap.
Yeah! People just don't get used to playing to no audience. If I could have one wish.
I've been doing it for 15 years.
Oh!
Even then.
Alright. Well done. Yeah, you missed it. That was right there. Yeah, most bands are just kind of weirded out playing to a corner, but.
Not me, no. Not us, man. No. It's all about the music.
What was that last song about? That was another rocking.
I don't even know, man.
No? Do you write kinda, most of it?
Lately. Yeah. We're all writing stuff, eh? Oh. He was making a riff up one night, and he said, you know, we should write something like, so it ain't no saint, like something kind of with the band name, right? And then I had the dream one night that I was opening up for Chris Cornell and Johnny Cash. Johnny's been dead for years, and I don't know, I was singing some, you know, this line and that line, right? And I woke up, I was like, Christ, I better write that down, right? And then I kind of just, I don't know. We talked about it and had some jamming and a few drinks and kind of fabbed up a couple other lines here and there. And then it came to that. No matter of what, 2 weeks, we wrote that. So
yeah, it was even. It was probably faster than that, actually.
Yeah, so. No, it turned out good. Kind of a fun song.
A few days.
As you guys were playing, I put together that Sinners of Saints is SOS.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's our.
That's where it comes from.
Yeah. Well, actually, I heard the in a lyric of a song on the radio is a Rolling Stones song that Sympathy for the Devil.
Yep. Also covered by Guns N' Roses.
There's a line in it where he's like all sinners saints, and I was like, oh, sinners of saints. I was thinking, or sinners or saints, and then Jay Bird decided to go, how about O saints, and so. That's what we went with.
And we were in a hurry to find a band name, too, because the girl that was in charge of the show in Weyburn for that Ryderville contest, she was texting them. I was at work, eh? We got to come up with a band name. They're going to announce it in 2 days. Or not even, like a day or something, eh? And we come up with everything from, we're just around, right? But $2 and change to the Pale Feeders to the Bale Haulers to, I don't know, this and that, Red House. There was a bunch of stuff, eh? Like, and then all of a sudden, Sinners of Saints. Yeah, that'll work. Cool.
Done. SOS.
Yeah. And then even though it kind of, you know, didn't quite fit, but they'd already announced it on the radio, so.
Who did the art for you? That's pretty.
I did that really quickly on my computer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, you guys.
I Googled a picture of the Earth, and then I broke it all up and gave it horns.
Nice.
Halo.
I like it.
RS signs.
That's
and,
if you notice, the SOS is incorporated in that. The Earth is supposed to be kind of like an O.
Oh, I thought the halo was the O. I guess it both works.
Oh, both work, yeah. And the backwards S on the other side there, so, yeah.
People think you're like a religious band or something at first? Yeah.
Oh, really? Until
they look at me and see nothing to do with religion.
Oh, I have
straight out rock and roll and
living this
and is
awesome.
A good time, man.
We have to gear up for our first commercial break, but dare I say stick around. We got more PG television with Sinners of Saints
gonna
coming
need a
up
cigarette
right after this. Mr. Sicily Pizza and Pasta is proud to sponsor community programming on Shaw TV. Mr. Sicily, located at the corner of 51st and Miller in the north end of Saskatoon. 975-0345.
Do you know where stuff goes once it's flushed down the toilet?
It travels down pipes under our streets to a sewage treatment plant. There it is cleaned up through a variety of processes before it is sent back out in our lakes or rivers. The problem occurs when people flush things down the toilet like makeup, cleaning supplies, and some pharmaceuticals that the sewage treatment plant can't clean up. They are dumped untreated into our waterways, which other people depend on for their drinking water. Some cities continue to dump their sewage untreated into our waterways, while others are using innovative thinking to reuse sewage byproducts as fertilizer. What can you do? Be sure to properly dispose of any chemicals or unused medicine at your city's hazardous waste disposal site.
It's our turn to take care of this planet, and I think we can do a better job. What do you think?
Back, you're watching Strip Down. We're spending 60 minutes with sinners, oh saints. Even the bad language has caused the cameras to go all funky. This is awesome tonight. It has been a while, let me tell you. It feels good tonight. It's like the original crew is back together. For the last month, we've had such amazing people like Mr. Brock Andrews step in and do audio in our audio guy's absence. Then we had the nostalgia tour with Colton Wall, who did our audio for the first three seasons of Strip Down. And then at the end of last season, he handed the reins over to our new audio guy, who has been gone for a month. Returning tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the Sultan of the Sliders, Mr. Bennett Dodney. Welcome back, Ben. Ben! Yay! Where were you?
Well, for the first part of April, I was in Banff.
Yeah.
Studying some concert band music stuff, and that was a great time. And then I was off to Vancouver for a couple days on the way out to China and down to San Francisco and then over to China for 13 days. Nice. Just got back last night, actually.
Yeah. I was worried you were going to miss a flight and not make it or something, but you came through. I know you're mad tired. You're still 13 hours ahead of the rest of us, but you're here tonight. Sounding great. What does Ben Dobney do in China? Like, where do you even start?
A lot of different stuff, actually. Like, went to a lot of Buddhist temples, nice. Ate a lot of good food. The food was incredible. Like everybody who's asked me about anything to do with China so far, I've just told them that the food was great.
So you went to Buddhist temples for the food?
Yeah, that's nice. True, actually. There's like a good vegetarian restaurant attached to each Buddhist temple, and they like simulate meat really well. So I ate a lot of simulated meat.
You know, vegetables is what food eats, eh?
Wow, that's nice. The first time somebody's interrupted the talk with sorry, the audio guy. No, that was
well worth it.
We're breaking new grounds tonight.
I suppose, eh?
Ben, welcome back.
Oh, thank you.
Did you miss
Curtis.
Us? You know, you're in the temples in China, missing Strip Down, weren't you? That was all you could think about.
I'll humor you on that one. Yeah,
yeah, sweet. Welcome back, Ben. We got another, like,
thank you.
Six, seven shows before we're done season four. And
yeah.
Then we'll, I can expect you back for season five, right?
You bet.
Right?
Yeah, for the first half.
Sweet.
Looking forward to it, Curtis. Thank
you. Bennett Dobney, back, taking the reins.
Thank you.
Back to Sinners, Oh Saints. You guys having fun tonight?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, again, you're wearing a jacket. It's heating up in here.
It is, man.
You made it, too. I don't think we've ever had a band member run out and have a smoke during the, like, two-minute commercial break, but you did it. You were back in
betcha.
Time. What's the connection with you guys and Kerry Senko? Kerry Senko playing with, what is it, the Time Pirates recently? Is that what they're called?
We saw them at, we saw her at Open Jam.
Okay, she was supposed to be here tonight. She was on the show during season three. You can see her on the intro each week on Strip Down. She was with a new band. They were going to come on tonight. We had it booked months in advance. She canceled. I said, another cancellation. She said, no, I got a backup band. I booked one for you. I said, you're awesome, Kerry Senko. You guys enter my life. Yeah. What's the connection with you and Kerry Senko? You just kind of know her?
Oh, we just kind of know her, yeah. I have her on Facebook, and she phoned me and said, hey, do you want to do this thing on Wednesday? And I said, well, I'll get back to you. I'll talk to the guys and see if that's possible. Everyone said yes, and here we are.
For sure.
Yes, Rob, and Rob said, blank, yeah. Yeah. We're in.
Not quite.
Blankety blank,
not
blank. Quite. Let's do blank and TV, blank.
It was something like that, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, she hosted a jam down in Regina there for quite a while there, too.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
And good turnout all the time. So,
what's the community, the musical community like in Regina? I never really know because it's super tight in Saskatoon. Yeah. Is it?
It's a little cutthroat down there. I'll admit it, man. Like it is. I mean, you know, when we started trying to get gigs, and oh, you're only charging that, and you know, undercutting people, so to speak. Eh? It's like, you know, come on. You know, if it's about the music, then whatever, right?
Then it should be about the music.
Well, exactly.
And Sinners of Saints, all about the music.
It is, man.
I like how you made your own genre too. That's good. Cause I'd have a hard time classifying you. Does that ever like bite you guys in the butt?
Nope.
When you're like trying to line up gigs?
Nope.
So you could probably play country bars and play regular bars?
We do everything from AC/DC to Johnny Cash, man, and everything in between, so.
Nice.
And then our original stuff we've been coming up with seems to kind of just flow right in with everything, so.
Well done.
So, yeah,
I'm really digging the sound tonight.
Cool, man. Thanks.
We were talking about the writing process before we took our first commercial break, and you just kind of getting the feeling that you all kind of contribute.
Yeah.
So do you guys just sit down, lock yourselves in a room, or do you go have a brewski or have a coffee, if you will?
Yeah, in his basement, usually.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No, some of the lyrics I wrote a few years back, and just kind of, and then we all kind of revamped them so they'd actually sound like a song and just not, you know, sitting around
and
the campfire
I have
sort
of tons
thing.
Of songs myself to be.
And he's got a whole pile of
practicing.
Written.
And, so.
Yeah. If only he could tell us about
it. It's only the beginning.
But he can't.
Yeah, where's your mic?
Because he didn't put a mic on.
That's his nickname.
He's a mute anyway. He doesn't speak. That's why he plays bass.
in your defense, they usually rag on the drummer when the bands come in. Everything's usually the drummer.
But he's got a mic on.
Yeah. That's true.
So we have to be nice to the drummer today.
Let's get to song number three. I understand it's kind of a short party song.
Yeah. It's one me and my old lady made up a while back, so it's kind of funny. It's called Long List of Reasons.
Got a long list of reasons why I should leave here. Why should I give you one today? But you've now running around this messed up town. I think I'll sit right here and have a drink. Should've known this night when you caught my eye the way you always do. You were three sheets to the wind, you couldn't tie your own bow. Now a pretty face might get you far in a worn out stinking smoking bar. Now you stumble around with somebody new. Ha, 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 ha. I got a long list of reasons why I shouldn't leave here. Why should I? Told me you'd be working late. It's Friday night and I'm sitting here still waiting for your day. No, a pretty face might get you far in a worn out stinking smoking bar. Now you stumble around with somebody new. I got a long list of reasons why I shouldn't leave here. Why should I give you one today? Even now I'm running around this mess of town. I called you Saturday night, you told me you'd be working late. It's Wednesday night and I'm sitting here still waiting for your day. And I see you there at the shooter bar, bragging about your brand new car that I bought you just the other day. I got a long list of reasons why I shouldn't be here. Why should I give you one today when you've been out? This backwards town, yeah, I think I'll sit right here and have a drink. Hey, bitch, why don't you sit and buy me a drink?
Pulling out the red net tonight.
That was awesome. We're spending 60 minutes with Regina's Sinner O' Saints.
Sinners.
Sinners.
Yeah.
There it is. Sinners O' Saints. It's my first night on the job. A lot of consistent themes in your songs. Where do you guys get inspiration when you're songwriting?
Life, women.
Drinking.
Life.
Mostly true stories, probably.
Booze, women, life.
They seem upbeat. Oh, yeah. Songs about true, yeah. Are you guys tortured souls on the inside, though?
Just
comes out in party form.
Very much.
Yeah. Here and there.
Here and there.
Again, just like every other musician, right?
You guys seem like the band that, you know, maybe wouldn't go looking for trouble, but trouble finds you.
Sometimes. Depends on the day of the week, right?
Yeah, and the venue.
Yeah, and if it's a full moon, if it's dark out, you know, there's a lot of things that
a lot of elements
come into play.
What's
here?
The craziest thing that's happened at a live gig? That's PG.
We already destroyed a hotel room.
You destroyed a hotel room?
Yeah, I think. Well, kind of messed it up. Not really destroyed it, but it was pretty messy.
That's pretty rock and roll, though.
Yeah,
but
it wasn't even our fault. It
and
was
then,
the women that we had here.
Equipment, and I booted him, gave him a shot in the head with my steel-toed boots, and down he went. And then the cops came, and then there was a fight outside, and that was a good time. bunch of people scrapping. We're hauling drums out the door. He's like this with his drums. Excuse me. He's kind of stepping over him. The guy, oh, yeah, sorry. And he's giving this guy a couple of shots out in the porch.
Oh, like, that really? Fight, yeah.
You guys are rolling right
it
out
was
of the
really
way
a fight.
For the band, eh? So
yeah.
It was pretty funny. Good times. Cheap entertainment, right?
So nice. Wow.
A few little things.
Couple that women. Was a better answer than I expected.
Yeah.
So I usually end with this question, but I kind of want to ask it now. What could people expect if they take in a live Sinners O Saints concert?
Well, probably
show.
Some pretty consistent rock and roll and some good upbeat music and good tight tunes, man.
And 96.4% sure they're not going to get booted in the head?
No, probably not.
Probably
unless they come up to the stage and try and mess around with their equipment or any of the guys, then, you know.
That's a bootin'.
Right?
Yeah.
So
playing with the pedals?
Yeah.
That's a bootin'.
We're a team, man.
Touching Rob's guitar? Yeah. That's a bootin'.
Well, yeah. I don't know if it can. I don't know if anybody can do any
that's
worse
the new band name,
I have,
man.
But
that's a bootin'.
Yeah, that's a story in itself. His guitar
best
is
best gig you guys have played. Where was the one where you kind of like looked at each other and were like, oh, this is awesome. This
oh,
is
there's
what
been
we're
a few, man.
Do.
Probably, there's been a few.
Probably either McNally's or
the Gaslight Saloon, possibly.
We should clarify, too, for the people watching in Saskatoon. McNally's is a bookstore in Saskatoon.
Really?
Oh.
And no, there are live music there. However, it's usually like one guy and a mandolin kind of thing.
We'd probably
so
burn the
people,
place
down. Yeah, people no, are probably scratching their heads going, you know,
McNally's.
Mildred fell off the back of her chair going,
oh, my lord,
McNally's.
Look at their emblem. They're not at the bookstore.
Yes. Yeah. So, no, but
no,
there's a pretty kicking bar in Regina called McNally's.
On Dune Ave, it's run by Rick Krieger. He's had all kinds of acts in there over the years.
Constantly,
like
daily. Like they have.
Yeah.
I keep trying to give all my Regina friends the nickname Dudney, but it doesn't stick. That's like the best, you know? That's
well, and then you can one up and go Dudney and Forth or Dudney and you know.
If I'm ever an actor, I'm going to be Dudney Scarth.
Nice.
That's pretty wicked stage name.
Dudney Scarth.
Dudney Scarth.
You'd have to wear a scarf and grow a bigger beard or something. It would go really.
It'd be a cobblestone. Because Scarth's cobblestone.
Get an Amish hat.
Yeah, we're talking about two completely different things, aren't we? It's like we're both saying English words, but they're just not connecting. That last song, you and your old lady wrote it.
My girlfriend, yeah. No, I started writing and we were sitting around one night and I said, oh, I listen to this or whatever. And then she was, well, you gotta have some kind of a story that kind of
do I want to know what the story
on.
Was about?
Oh, yeah, it's a true story about myself years ago, about some dizzy woman from down in the southern part of the province.
Dizzy, that's little another good word.
Dizzy.
Kind of like flanged.
Yeah. Dizzy.
Oh, okay.
No, it's that's just, you know, one of them songs. You know, every guy goes through that, some girl, and, you know, oh, yeah. And then, you know, you head out, and oh, there she is, hammered with somebody else.
but not all of them get songs.
Not all the time, and I'm not saying everybody's like that. I used to be like that. Until I turned 34, and then I thought, okay, it's time to settle down. Yeah, I found the halo.
Well, I'm just going to cut that off right here. Let's get to another song before we take our next commercial break.
What?
There should be warning lights all over the place. Bail. Where do we go next?
Oh, are we going to play? Okay,
yeah, let's play.
Afternoon Blues.
Yeah, Afternoon Blues.
Afternoon Blues.
Woke up this morning, you were gone.
Woke up this morning, you were gone. When I rolled over, I felt the crumple of the nose.
Yeah, we're spending 60 minutes with Sinners, Oh Saint. We're just a little over halfway done. We got to take our second commercial break, but stick around. You're not going to want to miss the second half of this show. We got lots more Stripped Down coming up after this break.
My heart you stole, and next is my soul. My heart you stole.
Look at that!
Yeah, thank God she's a half a mile away, huh?
She's loaded, boys! You gotta get out of here! It's full of explosives!
Children! Come on!
Oh, no! Don't get out of here!
Vince!
Come on back in the school!
Please, get these children out of here! That ship is gonna blow! No!
Mr. Coleman!
Hurry! Hurry! You gotta get these people out of here! That ship is gonna blow! The train.
What?
People, get out of here! It's gonna blow up!
Mission ship on fire. Stop train.
Coleman, there's no time.
The train's coming in towards Pier 6. I've got to warn you.
Come on, Vince, come on.
There are 700 people aboard it. I've got to stop it.
Come on, acknowledge.
Halifax was devastated. 9,000 wounded, 2,000 dead, including Vince Coleman, dispatcher.
Mr. Sicily Pizza and Pasta is proud to sponsor community programming on Shaw TV. Mr. Sicily, located at the corner of 51st and Miller in the north end of Saskatoon. 975-0345.
We're back.
Yeah, that's what happens when the lead singer, the front man, goes out for a smoke break and the commercial breaks. Made it the first time. Welcome back. That was fun. I got some exercise.
Yeah,
feel good. I inhaled your secondhand smoke and had some exercise, so I think I evened out. All right. During the break, we watched one of those epic heritage moments. And honestly, one of my dreams when it's all said and done, it doesn't matter what I do with the family, it doesn't matter what I do with the career, I want my own heritage moment. You know, I want to be able for my grandkids to watch and be like, and then in 2020, Curtis Anderson became the most unliked Canadian in the history of Canada. Yeah, well, maybe not that far. This guy called me serial killer. It would have been hilarious. It would have been super funny, but he wasn't wearing a mic because he turned down the mic offer at the beginning of the episode. So, if Sinners, Oh Saints gets their own heritage moment, what'll it be for doing?
Oh, where to start?
When they look back and there's that awesomely tranquil voice going, in 2012, Sinners and Saints redefined the rockabilly rock thrash genre.
Yeah, it's the number one genre in the world.
Yeah.
Bit of everything.
What are you guys going to be recognized for doing?
I don't know. I think just trying to build our own sound and just kind of keep it, you know, mainstream's mainstream, but just kind of push the envelope a bit, but not go too crazy.
Mission,
like, we're all from totally different.
We'd probably be known
too.
For the Beavis and Butthead impression that Rob does really good.
Maybe.
Oh, you gotta grace us with that. Beavis and Butthead. Come on, man, we're all waiting.
That's all you get.
That's it. Waiting. Next time you come on, we want an hour just to Beavis and Butthead.
I can't even remember that.
Well,
show.
Well, it looks like you're getting ready to rock.
Yeah,
so.
No guitar. So, I got no equipment for my electric.
Yeah.
So it's going to sit
right
there.
You're fueled up on nicotine. You've got the handheld mic, so I'm expecting something big.
Yeah, this next
okay, you haven't disappointed me yet.
Right on.
There might be fist pumps, might be some Axl Rose spinning, something like that.
Might be falling on the drums like a month ago, you never know. At least you got no stage to fall
That's
off.
Never happened. Yeah.
Everyone at home, hit record on your VCR or PVR, because here we go.
Yeah, get the fire extinguisher out.
Sinners, Oh Saints, take it away.
Falling on this ground is where I am. You
You're watching Stripped Down. We're spending 60 minutes with Sinners Oh Saints. What was that last song about? That was pretty rocking.
You like that,
yeah,
eh?
That's I did about, like that.
That one I wrote quite a while ago. It's about my ex-wife.
Okay.
say no more, I guess, pretty much about that one.
Kind of
it's a little on the angry side. But
I caught that. What's it like watching somebody else sing a song about your ex-wife? Is that kind of weird, or is that just exactly what it should be?
He's a way better singer than I am. So, yeah, so that's... And he does it pretty good. Like, he does it a different style than me, but...
Yeah.
But he made it his own, so...
Thanks, brother.
You guys really have a unique sound.
Yeah, you like
yeah,
that.
Like, yeah, like, I don't want to make it sound lame, but it's very accessible. Like... Yeah. I was thinking, man, I really like this. You know, my parents are going to watch, and they'll probably like it. Like, it's very accessible.
It's a little rockin', eh? It's got some attitude.
Accessible. See, you know, it was really dramatically accessible there, too. The lights dipped. Yeah. It said accessible, and the lights dimmed. We have to take our last commercial break, but we wrap things up with Sinners Oh Saints coming up right after this. Now up. Yeah, there you go. See?
But I was afraid.
Mr. Sicily Pizza and Pasta is proud to sponsor community programming on Shaw TV. Mr. Sicily, located at the corner of 51st and Miller in the north end of Saskatoon. 975-0345.
Do you know where your tap water comes from?
It can come from one of two sources, groundwater or surface water. Surface water often begins as snowfall that accumulates in the winter and melts into our rivers and lakes. Cities will treat it to get rid of most of the impurities and then send it down the pipes, under the streets, and into our homes. The problem is, the quality of water is being damaged by our activities, and as our earth warms up, there may be less water available in the future. How can we look after our water resources? Find out where your water comes from and how it is being protected. Use less when you're showering, brushing your teeth, or watering your lawn. And never pour toxins like cleaning solutions down a toilet, sink, or storm drain as it ends up in our rivers and lakes.
It's our turn to take care of this planet, and I think we can do a better job. What do you think?
Ladies and gentlemen, Sinners Oh Saints.
I won't live this way, don't waste another day. Had to get this on my chest, it's been too long. We'll be right back. away. Don't waste another day. Had to give this all my chance. It's been too long. Fighting feelings inside me. If you could change, someday we'll say. But for now, bitch, yeah, I'm gone. Long gone. He's in a last hold right, and it don't matter. I just wish that you'd get better someday. Some way. By the way, I damn well knew each time that you were out and up to today. Well, every day, yeah. You know when you're gone, what you do. Well, how would you like if I had done the same to you? Same to you, same to you. Yeah, I wanna live this way, gonna waste another day. Been too long, five demons inside me. If you can change someday, we'll see. But for now, yes, I'm
wrapping things up with Sinners, Oh Saints, who are so great. They drove up from Regina to give us this amazing episode here at Strip Down. Now, there's an energy tonight that is not usually in this room.
Good to hear. That.
I was almost, it was awesome and rocking, but almost a little scary for me too. Like, I haven't felt that since our fifth episode, where we had a now defunct band called Doll Talk and Ransom on.
Oh, yeah.
And the lead singer, this wonderful girl named Heather, who at one point had a wireless mic and started dancing around. She climbed the stairs there and started moaning, and we couldn't play the episode. Oh. It was the only episode in the history of Strip Down we weren't allowed to air.
Well, I hope this isn't one of them.
No, we'll air this one out. I might have to beep a few words out here and there. But
two of them, I know. I bite my tongue. I'm sorry, I apologize.
There was more than two.
Was there?
There was more than two. But yeah, she scaled.
Had a couple of zeros.
She scaled the ladder and started moaning, and then we couldn't use the ladder anymore to climb on, and it was kind of bad news.
I suppose.
But it was a good episode. For the six of us that saw it, it was a good episode.
Nice. Private show.
That was my shout out to Heather from Charm Offensive's new band.
Nice.
You guys in the studio right now.
Yep.
Getting four songs done. Yeah. Get more. What's the timeline here?
Well, hopefully by the end of June, to tell you the truth.
Yeah. But you'll have something out.
Yeah.
Well, probably a little longer. Probably by the end of summer.
Okay.
Hopefully.
We're hoping to.
Yeah.
We have enough. We just got to hash them out, right? And then going for that Rollco grant, I think, with the four that we do have. So, and that'll help us a lot because it's.
There's people at Rollco that watch the show regularly. So make your plea real quick, man. Make your plea.
Rollco, we'll make you money and we'll make good music, I swear.
Bam!
There it is. There's the. Yep. Yeah.
All right.
That's all I have to say.
For more information, where do people go? Do you guys have a website?
Yeah, just on Reverb Nation, type in Sinners O Saints. Sinners O apostrophe Saints. Okay. And there's a few other bands, Saints and Sinners, but we didn't rip
them
off.
I think if you're going to like key it in, it would be like Reverb Nation. .com/SinnersOSaints1
Wow, it's like you have a magic finger because it just came up when you were pointing that.
Yeah.
Right, there it is.
There it is right
they
there.
Say television's all smoke and mirrors, but it was right there.
I had to visualize writing it out so I can remember what it was.
Okay, the disc drops. You guys going to send it out there
over the internet. What comes after that? You gonna tour, support, just play wherever you can?
Yeah, hopefully that's one. We're gonna, I just know it. We all know it, man, for sure, man. It's all about the music.
This is the one, this is the ticket.
Yeah. This is the year.
We are out of
good
time.
Live music.
Thank you guys so much.
Yeah, seriously. No problem, man. Thank you guys.
So much fun tonight with you guys. We got to wrap things up. Thanks to tonight's cast and crew. Thanks to our sponsors, Long & McQuaid, Ultimo Urimoto, and Mr. Sicily Pizza, which we are minutes away from eating. And I'm very hungry. For all things Stripped Down, Facebook Stripped Down, you'll see the dancing girl. Hit like. We can use as many likes as possible. Tell your friends. That's the coolest thing these days, voting and hitting like on the Stripped Down fan page. Anyways, we are out of time. Ladies and gentlemen, here to rock us out. They're not really paying attention, but hey, we're back for the last time tonight, all the way from Regina, Saskatchewan. Ladies and gentlemen, to play us out of here, it's Sinners, Oh Saints. Thank you so much, you guys.
Appearance is not the best.